Portal Space Systems, founded in 2021 by former VP of Propulsion at SpaceX, Jeff Thornburg, is creating a stir in the space startup market. Thornburg is the mastermind behind SpaceX's Raptor engine for the Starship system. The company, based in Washington and Seattle, is developing an advanced spacecraft with a new propulsion technology that promises very high delta V. In simple terms, delta V represents the total maneuver budget for a vehicle. The higher the delta V, the more you can move in space. This high-end maneuver capability means it can zip between different orbits, from low Earth orbit to medium orbits to geostationary orbits, moving more often than traditional vehicles. We'll look at the propulsion system in detail later, but first let's look at some of its other capabilities. The Supernova spacecraft, as Portal calls it, supports in-orbit refueling, enabling it to remain operational for months or even years. This capability opens the door to missions previously considered impossible, not just around Earth, but also in cislunar space and beyond. Designed for both civilian and military applications, Supernova's high delta V has caught the attention of the US Department of Defense and Space Force, both of which have thrown their support behind the company. With this kind of versatility, it's no surprise the military sees huge potential in the system. Okay, let's look at the new propulsion system. Solar Thermal Propulsion, or STP for short. Traditional space propulsion systems force a tough choice: high thrust or high efficiency, but never both. Portal Space Systems changes that with their Supernova spacecraft, powered by solar thermal propulsion. This technology delivers nuclear-like performance without the need for an onboard nuclear reactor. Nuclear propulsion isn't new. It worked in tests back in the 1960s, but it's never taken flight. The risks and legal headaches of launching radioactive materials into space has kept it grounded. Portal Space sidesteps this entirely by tapping into a massive nuclear reactor already in place, the Sun. Why build a reactor when you can harness our local star's energy to heat propellants instead? Their solution mimics a childhood trick: using a magnifying glass to focus sunlight into a scorching point. Portal's solar concentrator does the same, channeling the sun's rays to heat propellant to energy levels rivaling those of a fission reactor. The result? Intense power, no radioactive baggage. According to a 55-page report from Portal's investors at Mach 33, the link is in the video description, this solar thermal system achieves 90% of nuclear thermal propulsion's performance at just 10% of the cost. Why solar thermal propulsion? Today's spacecraft and satellites rely on propulsion systems with clear limitations. Chemical thrusters pack a punch with high thrust, but burn through fuel inefficiently. Ion thrusters, on the flip side, sip fuel efficiently, but deliver such tiny thrust that orbit changes can take weeks or even months. Portal Space Systems breaks this compromise with their Supernova spacecraft. This new type of propulsion technology offers both high thrust and high efficiency, no trade-offs required. With STP, the Supernova generates 100 newtons of thrust using ammonia, achieving a specific impulse of 400 seconds. Switch to hydrogen and it hits an impressive 800 ISP. The thrust drops to about half. Either way, it easily outperforms traditional systems. Beyond power, solar thermal propulsion keeps things light. The system weighs in at just 80 kilos, thanks to lightweight solar concentrators and a simple single propellant feed. Compare that to ion thrusters, which tip the scales at 300 kilos due to bulky solar panels, or chemical thrusters, which lug around 100 to 200 kilos of tanks, lines and pumps. Like ion thrusters, STP offers unlimited restarts, something chemical thrusters can't match. But where it really shines is cost. Ammonia, a go-to propellant for solar thermal propulsion, costs a mere $1 per kilo. Xenon, commonly used in ion thrusters, runs a staggering $2,500 per kilo. Plus, STP hardware is reusable. Refill the ammonia tank and you've got another 6 kilometers a second delta V ready to go. Thrust-wise, STP strikes a smart balance. It far exceeds the feeble push of ion thrusters, while falling short of chemical thrusters' raw power. The real win? Value. STP outclasses ion thrusters' exorbitant propellant costs and chemical thrusters' heavy, short-lived hardware with limited restart potential. In short, solar thermal propulsion delivers standout maneuverability at a fraction of the cost. It handles small, medium, and large delta V maneuvers efficiently, all without demanding massive power or oversized propellant tanks. For missions needing flexibility and reasonable timelines, STP sets a new standard. Portals technology platform. To grasp Portals' edge over competitors, let's dive into their technology and the performance boost it delivers. Unlike traditional systems that burn chemicals or accelerate ions, Portal harnesses the sun's power to drive a spacecraft forward. Their solar thermal propulsion system uses mirrors to concentrate sunlight, heating a propellant that expands and blasts out of a nozzle to generate thrust. It consists of two key pieces of technology, the solar concentrators and the heat exchanger and thruster. Let's look at both of these components next. Solar concentrators. Portal's team has crafted lightweight, highly reflective mirrors that unfurl in space to capture sunlight. Instead of converting that light into electricity, like solar panels do, these mirrors focus it directly into a small chamber. Through clever design, they achieve sky-high concentration ratios, producing intense heat from compact, lightweight reflectors. This direct heating skips the energy conversion losses that plague ion thrusters, which first turn sunlight into electricity. In sunlight, the system delivers steady heat and thrust. Even in Earth's shadow, a thermal battery keeps the vehicle pushing forward for a while. Now, onto the second key piece. Heat exchanger and thruster. The concentrated sunlight beams into a patented heat exchanger, holding the spacecraft's propellant, likely ammonia for now, with hydrogen on the horizon. This component, a tough nut for rivals to crack, features 3D printed parts with intricate internal channels and surfaces. These maximize heat transfer from the chamber's hot walls to the propellant. No combustion here, just pure heating. The propellant expands and rockets out of the nozzle, driving the spacecraft with high efficiency. Operating at extreme temperatures, the heat exchanger achieves an ISB, or specific impulse, of about 400 seconds with ammonia. Two ingredients fuel the system, sunlight and a single propellant. Refuel it and the vehicle runs indefinitely. Portal aims for thrust between 50 and 200 newtons, depending on the propellant and setup. Supernova, solar thermal propulsion powered spacecraft. The Supernova satellite bus is engineered from the ground up for maneuverability, using its novel solar thermal propulsion system. Jeff Thornburg, CEO of Portal Space Systems, explains, "The space industry hasn't fundamentally improved satellite bus technology in decades. Our nation is developing sixth generation fighter aircraft technology, but still uses first generation satellite buses. Portal Supernova is designed around the customer need for unparalleled mobility and extended mission life," unquote. While today's satellites can be placed in orbit with precision, they remain largely static, other than station-keeping maneuvers, due to their inefficient propulsion systems, at least in comparison to Supernova's propulsion. Portal Space Systems promises nuclear-level performance without the nuclear complexity, just sunlight cleverly harnessed. Portal system is scalable. Need more thrust? No problem. Add more reflectors and a bigger heat exchanger. Current status. In the first quarter of 2025, Portal announced a $17.5 million seed round. It's preparing for integrated testing of its propulsion system. Hardware-in-the-loop tests are underway and the company is preparing for its first orbital demonstration. Upcoming events. In the second half of 2025, Portal Space Systems will kick off systems integration testing. They'll put the Supernova platform through a full workout, testing its propulsion, power systems, thermal heating, and control subsystems. This crucial step will iron out any risks ahead of the first flight demo. In summer 2026, Demo 1 will launch the Supernova prototype into low Earth orbit. This first flight will showcase core abilities like maneuvering and station keeping. By 2027, Demo 2 will take flight as an operational mission prototype. Tailored to a military customer like Space Force, this demo will simulate a defense-relevant scenario. Think rapid threat avoidance or orbital repositioning. Later in 2027, Portal aims to deploy multiple Supernova vehicles into orbit. This fleet will demonstrate on-demand mobility, ready to shift positions at a moment's notice. In 2028, Portal will ramp up to low-rate production, targeting 12 vehicles per year. Looking to 2030 and beyond, Portal plans to go public. The Supernova platform will evolve into swarms of autonomous space drones, tasked with protecting and servicing high-value orbital assets. By 2040, Portal will expand to cislunar space, the Moon and Mars. Their propulsion system will power rapid cislunar transport, support lunar platforms, and bolster Earth's mega-constellations. Finally, Portal will tackle the next frontier, nuclear propulsion. Superheating propellants with an onboard nuclear reactor will turbocharge performance, slashing travel times for deep space missions. This speed will prove vital for human trips to Mars and beyond, cutting exposure to cosmic radiation. Thanks to their mastery of thermal management in Supernova's heat exchangers, Portal stands uniquely positioned to pioneer nuclear thermal propulsion systems. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.